Amazing day! Unreal Engine 5.7 is officially, finally here! It is an all-in-one solution for creating animations, virtual characters, video games, movies, you name it. This is a blockbuster release, and we will look at three incredible things it can do. And before we start, don't forget, all this is available for free for most people and applications. 1. Let's start with my favorite. This is Substrate, a material creation system, and the realism it can bring to our screens is next level. Why? Well, first, Unreal can run a light simulation with millions and millions of light rays hitting this object, and Substrate tells us how the material should respond to that. That already sounds like science fiction. But here is where it gets better. You can set up this imaginary object with whatever material properties you can imagine. And even better, you can do multiple layers of this. That is where realism gets to the next level. With Substrate, you can define a piece of metal as the core of the object and put a smooth colored coat over it. And then simulate how light is bouncing between these layers. That's incredible. For the longest time, this sounded like a fun little science experiment. Lots of research papers that I absolutely love. But let's be honest, it was still not practical enough for the industry. And now, get this, Substrate is now finally production ready. I am a light transport researcher by trade, and I spent so many years learning about these multi-layer simulators, and to see the papers finally come alive for millions of people for free, I am floored. Loving this. Note that we are not affiliated with the Unreal people in any way. But 2. All this light simulation isn't worth anything if the underlying geometry is not detailed enough. I don't just want a bunch of spheres, I want a fully detailed forest with all kinds of plants everywhere. And that's what the new Nanite foliage system helps with. This can render millions of tiny little elements on your screen, but it also does something we call level of detail really well. Level of detail means the engine quietly swaps between simpler and more complex versions of the same object, depending on how far you are from it. If you are far away, just render a few triangles, you don't need so much detail anyway. And whenever we go closer, it suddenly swaps in the more detailed geometry. Okay, but this concept has a flaw. It is clear as day to all of you fellow scholars that we have these popping artifacts here when the swaps happen. Now, hold on to your papers, fellow scholars, and have a look at the new system. So, did you see it? Did you see a pop? Not a chance, right? And that's the point. Under the hood, there is lots of magic to help your machine calculate as little as possible. And it swaps the geometry so seamlessly, you don't even see it working. And yet, it saves you tons and tons of resources. Brilliant work. But we are not done yet. Not even close. So we have good light transport and good geometry. But that is still not nearly enough to get a good-looking scene. What about light sources? Well, there is a nice surprise there too. Dear fellow scholars, this is 2-Minute Papers with Dr. Károly Zsolnai-Fehér. Dr. Carol. Light sources is where everything starts, after all. Is it not? Now, 3! This is Megalights. This is a system that gives you hundreds and hundreds of these beautiful lights in a black market scene, each of which are casting their own shadows. And all this in real time. And we're talking proper soft shadows. And it just got better. It can give you directional lights, shadow casting particles, and shadowing on hair. Also, higher visual quality, better performance, and less noise. Pooh! This is incredibly difficult, because during a light simulation, each one of your rays has to find a light source. But most rays don't do that. It's like throwing thousands and thousands of darts into the darkness, hoping to find a small, glowing target. There are so many ray tracing papers on how to do this more efficiently, and you see a masterclass of that in Unreal Engine. and with Megalites, finally moving from experimental to beta this release. Nice! Much more stable than before, but still not final. But I am so happy to see that the papers are coming alive and are put into the hands of millions of us fellow scholars. So cool! But we are not done yet. This was a scholarly look at three core technologies, but these three amazing other features also really caught my eye. Let's have a quick look. One amazing update to MetaHuman. MetaHuman is a realistic person creator, if you will. This is a combination of a ton of papers that we talk about here. For instance, the hair has to be simulated correctly, often strand by strand. The appearance of skin has to be correct, and deformations to the skin also have to be simulated correctly. And earlier, we showcased MetaHuman Animator, where we can scan ourselves and enter a real world as a video game character. And this character is able to mimic our gestures too. Now, I was thinking that all this sounds fantastic, but now, put your mouth where your papers are. Let us do it in real time. That is the real test. And here it is! I can't believe it! LiveLink Face lets you capture your facial expressions in real time through a camera and put it on the video game character. Whew. Two, you now have better ways to get a virtual haircut. Just pull these sliders around and you can assemble a completely new one. Plus, you can also animate it as if it were the body of a character with these little imagined joints. Really cool idea. 3. More realistic physics interactions for characters. So you can feel like a real computer graphics researcher and do these perturbation tests that we love to do. Once again, just thinking that all this is free for most people and projects. Goodness! It is all available through the link in the video description. Check it out and let me know in the comments what crazy projects you use Unreal Engine for. I'd love to hear that. And make sure to check out Lambda 2. They are amazing and they make 2-minute papers possible. And I got to say, I can't stop playing with OpenAI's OpenGPT model through Lambda GPU Cloud. And yes, this is actual speed. I can't believe that I can have more than 100 billion parameters running super, super fast here. Many of you fellow scholars are using it, and if you don't, make sure to check it out. It costs only a couple dollars per hour. Insanity! You can rent an NVIDIA GPU through lambda.ai/papers or click the link in the video description.